Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to be talking a little bit about confidence. I think confidence is a really, really important attribute to have, not only from a personal and social perspective, but also professionally as well. The moment I started getting a lot more confident was the moment I started becoming more successful with interviews, with just my career progression, and even just trying out new things. Like, if I wasn't confident, I wouldn't have created this YouTube channel. Let me define, first of all, what confidence means to me. So for me, confidence means that you believe in your own source. When you are confident, you don't need validation from others, and you don't need to show off about how good you are at a certain thing either, because you yourself know. For me, that's kind of like my main definition of what confidence is. It essentially means that you know yourself, that you are enough, and you accept that. When you are a confident individual, you don't need to become like anyone, or you don't need to act like someone you're not, because you yourself know that you're enough. You're content with being you. I feel like you still can be a shy individual, but you can still be confident. Confident people are usually, in my opinion, perceived as being extroverted, outwardly loud. Yeah, just really kind of, they know what they're doing. They have a set goal. When they walk into a room, they command the room, that kind of thing. And I think actually someone can be introverted and someone can be quite shy in nature, but they can still have confidence. They just don't outwardly show it. Like, they themselves still know that they're enough. So if you're watching this and you're thinking, I'm a really shy individual, I can never be confident, I think you can still maintain confidence and contentment with yourself. You're just not as loud about it as loudly confident or extroverted people are, if that makes sense. Some people may disagree with me on this, but that's essentially what I think. That's essentially what I think about confidence. And I also think that when you label someone as shy or introverted, sometimes that makes that person feel like I can never develop confidence. I think confidence is something that can definitely be built. And for me personally, I'm still building it. Like, I'm not going to sit here and say I'm the 100% most confident person in the world. I'm still learning as well, but I'm just merely sharing things that have really helped me in building my confidence. And hopefully there's some takeaways that you can take away from here. So I guess the main thing that I just want to say is, first of all, you may be watching this and you're like, I'm an introvert, I'm never going to be confident. That's not the case, in my opinion. You can still be introverted and still be confident. I hope that made sense. So let me start off, first of all, like I mentioned before, that I'm still building my confidence. Let me start off with my confidence back in the day. So I'll talk about kind of like my school and that kind of period. I was a confident person, I guess, in my friendship group, but I wasn't the popular person at school, definitely not. I was really clapped at school, I was butters. so I was definitely not one of the popular ones. When it came to people outside of that friendship group, I used to feel really insecure, and I used to always feel like I was inferior to that person. And there were also times where I wished that I was like someone, or I wish kind of I looked like someone and that kind of thing. So that, for me, when I look back, made me feel as if I don't have enough confidence, because I'm not content with myself. I wasn't content with myself at that time. And a lot of that confidence issue came from the views of other people. Like, for example, this is quite funny when I look back, but at the time I was really insecure about it. And that one comment that someone made actually really affected the way I perceived myself facially, like from my face. It still really made me acknowledge that now, if that makes sense. So it's crazy. It was just one comment that someone said, and it was in drama. We were in like some kind of like play or drama class or whatever. If you're watching this and you were the person who said it, anyway, I doubt they're watching, but if they are, whatever. They might not even remember this. That's the thing. Like, when someone criticizes you or makes a comment, they probably forgotten about years to go, but you're still remembering it because it really impacted you. So essentially, someone in class said under their breath that I had a sixth head. I mean, it's true though, like, look. I mean, I cover it kind of well with my hair, but yeah, essentially that's what I was called at school. And that's what someone said under the breath. And for me, now I laugh at it because that's something that I accept. Like, yeah, I have, like, you know, I don't even have a six head. I'm pretty sure, like, it's a forehead, I think. A forehead. A full head. That's sick. So that person made that comment. I could tell from the face they immediately regretted saying that straight away. And then when I asked them, what was that you said? Even though I'd clearly heard it, they said it under their breath. They were like, oh, nothing, don't worry. And it was like, it's crazy how that one comment literally, I think it was made in like year 9 or year 10 of school, it stuck with me throughout uni. I still remember it now to this day, clear as day, as if it was yesterday. That was one of the things that really fed into my insecurities and how I portrayed myself. There was another incident where someone literally rated me 3 out of 10 at school. Imagine the violation, bruv. You literally rated 3 out of 10 at school, like. You gotta laugh. And yeah, I guess it's fair to say that when I was at school, my confidence, yeah, I really did aspire to want to look like someone else or be someone else. And that for me indicated that even though in my friendship group, I was fine, I spoke well, I was known, and I guess I am still kind of known as this. So if my friends are watching this, hopefully you do agree, but I guess I was kind of like the joker in the pack in the group. So that kind of element still remained, but my actual inner confidence, I think, has really developed throughout my like just life journey in general. And when I started university, that I think was when my confidence increased a little bit, but I was still not fully content with myself. At university, like many other individuals, you leave school and that old perception of you is, you have the chance to basically start new, right? That old perception is gone. And that's when I was like, you know what, this is a chance for me to not have to lie about who I am or try and act like someone I'm not. Let me try and be my as authentic as I potentially can at university. And I think I did succeed in that somewhat. I did make some genuine friends who liked me for me. And yeah, I think uni was really, really nice because of that, because I did try and maintain that authenticity. But I'm not gonna lie, there was still something at university where like, I was still somewhat insecure about myself. There was that comparison culture at university as well that I was really affected by with my cohort, for example, at law school. I think also at university, actually, my confidence in terms of my looks and my, like, you know, how I perceive myself, that increased. But in terms of how smart I perceived myself to be, that decreased. And I guess the reason for that was because at school, I was so used to not being top of the class, but also like being known as one of like the geeks or the smart ones at school. Whereas at university, everyone was smart. So that was the one time where I was like, yo, like my confidence in terms of how I perceive myself as being smart, that decreased. And that really did affect me professionally and put me at a disadvantage, because I saw myself as really inferior to the people in my year group. A bit of a fun fact, like the people who were in my year group at university were people like Eve Cornwell. Like Eve Cornwell was actually in my year at uni. We sat in like a couple of seminars. I don't know her that well, like at all. We were both in really different friendship groups. I mean, for me, I never even hung out with law students anyway. But yeah, that's a bit of a fun fact, maybe a bit of a claim to fame, I don't even know, a really far-fetched claim to fame, because I bet she doesn't even know me. But yeah, I think that if I just look at that, that was the kind of caliber of my cohort at university, and I just felt so out of depth. When I was at school, I was very, very used to being in a school where there were a lot of people who looked like me. So there were a lot of Sikhs at my school, there were a lot of Punjabi people, there were a lot of basically brown people at my school. And then I went to uni, I was like, yo, this is why we call it England, because then I clocked, like, we were actually the minority. And that was something that, again, fed into my confidence, because I just felt like I was inferior in respect of my cohort because of me actually realizing the obstacles that people of my background or any kind of underrepresented community, when you actually have that realization of, oh, privilege actually exists, that kind of thing. So that was like kind of my first realization of that element as well. And also there have been a few instances at university that really made me feel like a lack of confidence. But I want to do a video actually about like my honest truth about Bristol Uni, so I'll talk a little bit about that element later on. So all of those different things really fed into my confidence at university. In terms of looks, how I perceive myself, my confidence at university increased. But in terms of actually how I saw myself as smart or just, yeah, intellectual confidence decreased, I guess, when I was at university. So let me talk about how this lack of intellectual confidence mixed in with a little bit of insecurities about the way I looked, as well as that feeling that I felt inferior compared to people in my cohort at university. Now let me talk about how all three of those elements really affected me professionally. How did that put me at a disadvantage when I was applying for training contracts? So how this really affected me from a professional perspective, one thing was I was too worried about what people were thinking of me. So this came to things like, for example, the group task for assessment centers, or even things like when I was writing my application, I was like, oh, I don't want to appear like I'm showing off on my application, so I don't feel like I put in all of the details that really showed my achievements, because I was like, oh, I don't want to look like I'm showing off on my application. And in a group task setting, when I was at an assessment center, for example, I would be scared to share my contributions in the group because I would feel like, oh, they're gonna laugh at me, they're gonna think I'm dumb, all that kind of thing. So part of how that confidence and that lack of confidence affected me professionally was because I was too scared about what other people would think of me if I contributed, if I shared my opinion. And another thing about how it affected me professionally was actually because I was too worried about what other people were doing as well. At university, I was surrounded by individuals who were getting vacation schemes, training contract offers, attending networking events, and they were actually able to relate to conversations that these people were having about golf or horse riding or wine distillery stuff, like stuff that's really not in touch with what I do. So that was one feeling as well, in terms of really being worried about the fact that I wasn't even going to fit into this career because everyone was doing such great things and I just felt really, really inadequate in comparison. So when it came to things like application questions, for example, when they'd say, what makes you stand out, or why should we select you for the next stage? Or even in interviews, when people asked me that question, I genuinely didn't even believe that I was a suitable candidate, let alone instilling that confidence in them. So that's how it really affected my performance professionally, because I didn't believe in myself. And that element of not believing in myself really translated in job applications, in interviews, because I literally just thought, you know what, I do not even see myself as that individual or that candidate that you're looking for. So given all of that spiel about my insecurities and confidence and how it was really affecting me professionally, let me talk about how I started building my confidence. There was a moment during the application process, I think this was after I was rejected after my second assessment center. So I'd done two assessment centers at this point, I was rejected from both. And I had a little bit of a self-reflection period where I was like, look, Sim, you are clearly getting through to these stages and something is just not clicking right now. You are going to these assessment centers a hot mess. You are nervous, you are shaking, which is completely natural, but this was more so literally just nervous thinking I didn't belong, nervous because I felt like I was too worried about what other people are doing. Now let me talk about how, after that kind of moment of reflection, things that I practically did to start building my confidence, because that moment was literally like a light bulb moment for me. That was like, right, I think there is an issue here in terms of how I perceive myself. So when I was researching things like building my confidence, I read quite often, I know this is quite popular on TikTok, for example, people wake up at like 6 a.m. or 7 a.m. or whatever time, and then they start their morning off by writing validations of I am enough or I am worth it, that kind of thing, with their like Dalgona coffee and their views of the skyline in Manhattan. I always see stuff like that and I was like, I'm not gonna lie, I'm too lazy to do that. I'm not crapping on that concept of writing validations or manifestations at all, because I've not actually tried it, but I just wanted to actually implement a more practical means of building my confidence. However, I have heard that things like writing manifestations and validations do help individuals, but for me personally, that's not something that I've tried. So let me talk about some other things that I did. So the first thing is I really tackled the issue of constant comparison. And this is something that was quite difficult at first for me to undo. And it was a process, because it's literally something that I had a habit of doing since I was in school, when I was comparing myself to other people in my year. So one thing that I really do believe in, and I saw this quote on Twitter, it's just because someone is winning doesn't mean that you're losing. And I really, really repeat that in my head. You know how you have that one motto that you always repeat in your head? That is my motto that I always keep repeating in my head. And you might be thinking, Sim, that's the same as writing down your validations. It probably is, but I'm literally just too lazy to write down my validations. I'd rather just keep them in here. Another thing in terms of that point about constant comparison and reducing that is social media is literally a comparison field. As soon as you go on social media, on your phone, on Instagram, LinkedIn, like those are the two main areas for me, you will find a post about someone being successful, someone looking a kind of when instantly your mind is like, why is that not happening to me? And I guess one thing that really helped me is realizing that social media is an illusion. It's a facade. I think Skepta tweeted that one time. I'm getting all my inspiration from Twitter. I'm not gonna lie with these quotes. And that's another thing that I keep on repeating in my head. You're only gaining a snapshot of someone's life then and there in that photo or that post. I think that's one thing to really do keep in mind when you are scrolling on social media, and also taking breaks as well. But I think when it comes to actually taking breaks on social media, that's a good thing to do, but actually realize why you're taking a break on social media. And when you do go on back onto social media, on like say if you delete your Instagram profile or deactivate it, for example, when you decide to go back onto Instagram, there's no point in you taking a break if you're going to go back into those same habits that you had before you had that break. So whilst you're on your break, for example, really reflect on, okay, when I come back to the social media site, which will probably happen, what do I want? What changes do I want to implement to ensure that I do not fall into that same trap or be affected by seeing a certain post again? And that, I think that's really, really important. Now, another thing that I really did when it came to building my confidence was practicing self-respect. So trying to ignore that little voice in your head when you've made a mistake, for example, your voice is telling you, oh, you're so dumb, like what an idiot. Really practicing self-respect and acknowledging yourself when you get those thoughts that's just a negative thought that seeped through. From a legal perspective with training contracts, just because you've gotten a rejection, it doesn't mean that you're not capable to become a solicitor. It literally just means that maybe a certain element of your application just wasn't strong enough, or maybe you need work in this area, that kind of thing. So really try and gain that kind of positive thoughts in your head, because a lot of the time those negative thoughts really affect and influence your actions and the way you perceive yourself and the way you treat others. So within self-respect, for me, it means rewarding yourself for the small wins. So acknowledging the times when you have done well, acknowledging those small improvements that you've made in your life to ensure that you are working towards that bigger goal. And also a big thing is complimenting yourself. And I know there have been times in my YouTube kind of channel where I've not done that. Let me give you an example. But aside from that, one thing that I do try and do is when I am looking in the mirror, I try and think, oh, you know what, my hair is looking nice today, or this dress looks nice on me, that kind of thing. So really practicing that isn't arrogance, in my opinion. When you are an arrogant person, in my opinion, you're arrogant when you think people are below you, when you think you're superior to everyone. That's what arrogance means to me. But confidence is different to that. Confidence is literally all about you. You accept you. Now, a big thing towards improving my confidence was actually practicing respect towards other people. I've always been a respectful person, but I think one thing that has really helped me in improving my confidence is actually complimenting other people more, if that makes sense, and practicing kindness, because it actually is quite intimidating and quite scary sometimes to compliment someone. I did it literally yesterday on Twitter. This girl posted a photo and she was wearing this bucket hat that looked really, really nice. And I was like, oh, this hat's dope. I've never spoken to this girl before. Like, it was literally just a compliment. And from that, I felt really good about myself. And it felt good that I had contributed somewhat to building someone else's confidence up, if that makes sense. Really do practice not only self-respect, but respecting others as well. And I think another thing as well in terms of building your confidence is actually really reflecting on the environment and the people around you. If you are surrounded by toxic, judgy individuals, that can really, really affect your confidence. For example, you may not feel good about wearing a certain dress or a certain kind of like shoes or a bag because it's similar to another person in your group, and they will say something to you like, why are you wearing that? Or, you know, you're scared that they will laugh at you, that kind of thing. because you've seen them do that to other people. Because they've been toxic or judgy towards other people, you're scared that they're going to do the same to you. So one thing that I think is really, really important in terms of building your own confidence is don't be afraid to cut out people in your life who you feel like are toxic, are not good for your mental health, are really affecting your confidence, and surround yourself with individuals who share similar ideals to you, who want you to grow, who support you. Like in terms of my circle, if you guys are watching this, I'm really, really blessed to be in a circle where everyone is supportive and wholesome. There is no judgmental behavior. There is no toxic behavior within my group either. We all very much support each other. Like the first few subscribers on this channel, the first few people who promoted what I did were my close friends. We really do all support each other in terms of our endeavors and what we do. And I think that in turn, again, has really helped me build my own personal confidence as well, because I know that I'm in a circle where I feel supported, where people accept me for me, and then that helps me to accept myself for me as well. Another thing as well for confidence is always smile. And I feel like when you are smiling, like when I'm smiling now, I hope at home that made you feel like smiling back. And even if you are on a particular day where you're feeling really low, really insecure about yourself, and you've got like an interview, for example, even smiling at the interviewer, they may not smile back. They try and act a bit distant, so it puts you off. But if you are smiling, it actually naturally instills confidence, not only in the person listening to you, but in yourself as well. And it helps calm down your nerves and that insecurity that you're feeling. So always smile, it's a good thing. So there's two last things I want to say in terms of building confidence and what really helped me. First, I want to talk about self-acceptance. Personally, like I've got a forehead, like I can't do anything about that, you know, and I accept that. Like if anything, I feel like I've styled my hair to make it look okay with my forehead, and for me now it's part of my personality, you know what I'm saying? Like yeah, like I like it as it is. Even things like the color of my skin, I'm happy. I'm really, really proud that I'm a Sikh individual, I'm from Punjabi descent, that kind of thing. I'm incredibly, incredibly proud of that. And I think before at university, when I used to feel that inferiority of I'm different to other people, I'm from an underrepresented community, all the insecurities and lack of confidence that comes from that, I have really come to embrace that now. And if anything, it's helped me pick the right firm for me, because this is a firm that actually does accept me for who I am and loves the fact that I have come from this background, I'm of this religion, and I bring that difference to the firm, if that makes sense. So I'm really glad to be in an environment like that. And even things like I accept my accent, I accept where I'm from, I accept my mistakes, I own them, I understand that mistakes aren't things that define me, but they are things that I learn from. And yeah, I think all those little things, I just accept a lot of elements about what happens to me in life or how I perceive myself, I accept it as it is. And the last thing I want to say about what really helps me build my confidence is not giving a single toss about the haters.
Hey, I'm sorry, I didn't see you there. I was too busy blocking out the fucking bitches.
You will meet people in your life who do not agree with you, who will put you down, they just don't rate you. And there are two quotes here that really, really helped me with dealing with that element of people not liking you or people not agreeing with you or saying bad things about you, that kind of thing. The first quote is, if you're not going to take advice from that individual, why would you take criticism from them? It makes sense, right? Like you wouldn't take advice from a random stranger, would you? But you're taking criticism from them. Make it make sense. And the second kind of quote is something that I came across, and it's like, when someone says something bad about you, from that person's perspective, that's coming from a bad place for them. It's probably coming from a place of insecurity, maybe from a place of jealousy, maybe they're in a bad place themselves. So when you do get a hater or someone saying bad things about you, give them a little prayer and hope that they are able to overcome whatever adversity or bad things they're feeling in their life, because at the end of the day, that's how they're projecting what's happening. And you just gotta stay in your own lane, doing your own thing, thriving, succeeding, just doing you. You are enough. And yeah, I think that's all I want to say about this video. I think this might have been one of my favorite videos to film, I'm not gonna lie. I like this one. It's been a good reflection journey. If you have any further comments or if you found this video helpful, do drop a like and comment on the video, and also subscribe to my channel to hear more of my content. Thank you so much for watching.